Okay, so see here, first one we have formed Em sine of omega t, E of t. This one, its graphical representation, we have seen it number of times. Its polar form we have seen in the previous lecture, magnitude and angle. So magnitude you can use peak or RMS. In some books peaks you will find, in some books RMS you will find. While doing calculation, mostly we do calculation in terms of RMS. Okay, so here you can use RMS also that time, or otherwise polar form in terms of peak also you can represent, but while doing calculation RMS is used. Okay, when we'll see the numerical it will be clear to you. Then after omega t nothing is there, plus minus, so that's why 0 degree I have written. So magnitude and angle, so magnitude, peak or RMS, and angle, whatever is there after omega t. Now its graphical representation, all of you know, first positive peak occurs at 90 degree and so on. This one graphical, whatever this Em sine of omega t, as its magnitude and direction continuously changes with respect to time, it is having magnitude and direction. You can represent them in the form of phasor diagram. So phasor diagram we denote in S plane, it is having x axis as real axis, y axis as imaginary axis, positive negative, same as that of x and y axis. Okay, Em sine of omega t, it starts from origin and increasing positively. First peak occurs at 90 degree, first negative peak occurs at 270 degree, and so on. This one waveform is represented along positive real axis, and its magnitude is equal to the root mean square value. Okay, parallel to real axis will be the representation. Magnitude will be equal to RMS value, and arrow must be at its end, is the phasor diagram representation. Now E2t, Em sine of omega t minus 30 degree. So polar form will be magnitude, will be peak or RMS you can take. And after omega t minus 30 degree is there, that's the angle will be at an angle of minus 30 degree, will be the polar form. While doing calculations, rather than using this voltage in the form of sinusoidal, if you convert it into the polar, and polar if you are using for doing calculation, it becomes easy. Okay, so to make calculations easy, what we'll do, whatever the instantaneous voltage equation and current equation given to you, that we'll convert into the polar form. Okay, so whatever the first one waveform is red one, second one waveform E2t, here it is blue one. Okay, so now if you compare both the waveform, first one is Em sine of omega t, second one is Em sine of omega t minus 30 degree. As here minus is there, means what we can say, E2 lags E1 by 30 degree. Okay, whenever we say E2 lags E1 by 30 degree, what does it mean? Phase difference between the peak of both also will be what is the phase difference between the peak of E1t and E2t?
30 degree.
Correct. So if E1t peak occurs at 90 degree, at what degree E2t its peak will occur?
120 degree.
120 degree, accordingly you draw the waveform. Okay, and if you means this waveform will start from at what degree you will start it increasing positively? E2t
30 degree.
Very good. Okay, you can start this waveform from 30 degree increasing positively, and before 30 degree if you extend it, you can see somewhere it intersect to y-axis, means this one waveform is having negative value at origin. So if after omega t minus some angle is there, minus phi is there, what does it mean? This waveform is having negative value at origin. Okay, now this is the reference x-axis. Okay, reference x-axis. So positive angle we measure in anti-clockwise direction, and negative angle using protractor you measure in clockwise direction. Same concept here you have to use in phasor diagram. Minus 30 degree means this one phasor will be at an angle of 30 degree with reference to positive real axis or x-axis in clockwise direction. Okay. And magnitude will be equal to the RMS value. So here E1, Em sine of omega t will be along x-axis. Like this will be the E1, its RMS value. And E2, here you can see lags E1 by 30 degree. Okay. So what is the conclusion? In phasor diagram, lagging parameter we represent in which direction? See here, E2 is lagging E1 by 30 clockwise. Degree clockwise. Very good. Huh? This one, everyone, please keep in your mind. In phasor diagram, lagging parameter we represent in clockwise direction. And reverse is the thing for leading parameter. Okay. So this is polar form, graphical representation, and phasor diagram representation. Now the third one. Em sine of omega t plus 60 degree. The earlier one E1t, first one E1t is Em sine of omega t. This is Em sine of omega t plus 60 degree. So what we can say E3t leads. Why? Because positive is here. So E3t leads E1 by 60 degree. So plus 60 degree it is. Polar form will be, you can take magnitude as peak or RMS and at an angle of plus 60 degree. So it's a positive angle. So with reference to x-axis or positive real axis, positive angle we measure in anti-clockwise direction. So its phasor diagram representation will be phasor equal to its magnitude equal to RMS value at an angle of 60 degree in anti-clockwise direction. What, and E1t here, if you wanted to represent, it will be along positive real axis E1, and this is E3, whatever is represented here at an angle of 60 degree. So what we can say here, E3 leads E1 by an angle 60 degree. Leading parameter in phasor diagram, we measure or we represent in anti-clockwise direction. Okay, so as E3 leads E1 by 60 degree. So from 0 degree E1 starts. So 60 degree before 0, it will start E3. Okay. So if at 90 degree first positive peak of E1 occurs, then at 30 degree, first positive peak of E3t will occur. E3t will occur. Okay. And so on. This one you got the point. Okay. Now next one. So now while solving the numericals, while doing calculations, there is a need to do multiplication and division. Multiplication and division like V1 into I1 or V by I. So for that, terms must be in polar form. Whatever the instantaneous voltage equation, current equation, or impedance given to you, that must be in polar form whenever you wanted to do multiplication and division. Okay, so polar form we have seen magnitude and angle. Once instantaneous voltage or current equation given to you, how we can convert it into polar form, that just now we have finished. Okay, then sometimes there is a need to do addition or subtraction like Z1 plus Z2 or I1 plus I2 plus I3 or V1 minus V2. So whenever you wanted to do addition or subtraction, terms must be in rectangular form. A rectangular form is same whatever you have learned in complex numbers, that is the real and imaginary part. Here real part means always the resistance is there, and imaginary part means either XL or XC or XL minus XC is there. So real part will be always positive. It will never be negative, a real part. Why? Because a real part here is nothing but it's a resistance, and resistance can never be negative. Isn't it? So that's why real part will always be positive for impedance. If impedance you are writing in terms of rectangular form, then I am telling to all of you. okay, but not for voltage and current, that we'll see later on. But here rectangular form, so real part and imaginary part, and J or I complex variable you can use. So here, whenever you wanted to do addition and subtraction, terms must be in rectangular form. So instantaneous voltage and current equation, how to convert in polar form, we have seen. How to convert polar to rectangular, that we are going to see. First one, see, whenever you wanted to do division and multiplication, that part we'll see. So for division and multiplication, terms must be in which form? For multiplication and division, terms must be in which form?
Polar form.
Polar form, correct. And for addition and subtraction, terms must be in which form?
Rectangular.
Rectangular form. Okay. Now see, first one, here you have to do the division, just sample calculations I'm showing you here, so that concepts will be clear to all of you. How to do multiplication, division, addition and subtraction. Okay. So see here, here you have to do division. So terms are already in polar, so you can do directly division, magnitude, or multiplication also. For multiplication also, terms must be in polar. So whenever you are doing division or multiplication, magnitude you can multiply or divide. Okay, so see here, it's a division. What are the magnitude? 10 divided by 5. So directly you can do that. 10 divided by 5 will be 2. And what you have to do with the angle? See, whatever the angle, upper one is numerator, lower one is denominator, isn't it? Whatever the angle is there in the denominator, shift it to numerator. Okay, shift it to numerator. While shifting, you have to change its sign. Here it is a plus 20 degree. When you will shift it in numerator, it will become minus 20 degree. Okay, so 60 minus 20 degree will be what? 40 degree. Okay, similarly, see the second one now. 20 by 2 directly, 10 you can do, magnitude it is, you can divide it directly, like you do in mathematics. And what you do, what you have to do with the angle, see here it's a minus 30 degree. From numerator you have to shift this angle to from denominator, this minus 30 degree, you have to shift this angle to numerator. So its sign get changed when you shift from denominator to numerator, so it will become plus 30 degree. Okay, so 80 plus 30 degree will be what? 110 degree. So 10 at an angle of 110 degree. Division is clear. Any difficulty with this? Okay, if you have any difficulty, ask me. Multiplication. So multiplication, while doing multiplication, magnitude again you can multiply. So 2 into 4. It will be 8. And what you have to do with the angles, depending on their sign, you have to add or subtract. So here plus 60 degree plus 45 degree, both are positive, simply add them. So it will be 105. So 8 at an angle of 105 degree. Okay. Next one is, see, magnitude again, multiplication is here, terms are in polar, so directly you can multiply. So 5 into 2 will be 10. Okay, and what you have to do with the angle? 30 degree and minus 10 degree is there. So 30 minus 10 degree will be 20 degree. Okay, so any difficulty while doing multiplication and division on polar form, in polar form? You got it?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, next. Addition and subtraction. So while doing addition and subtraction, terms must be in rectangular form. So see here, terms are already in rectangular form. You already have done it in mathematics. Real parts you can add or subtract, and imaginary parts you can add or subtract. So 5 plus 3, it will become 8, and 6j plus 4j, it will become 10j. Okay. Second also, 4 minus 2, real part will be plus 2. And imaginary part, 10 minus 3j. So it will become 7j. Okay. So this one already you have studied in 12th or here also in first year. Rectangular form. Now what we'll do? Sometimes you have to do addition or subtraction and terms are in polar form. So for addition and subtraction, terms must be in rectangular. So polar you have to convert first in rectangular, and then you can do addition or subtraction. Okay, so how to convert polar to rectangular and rectangular to polar, that we'll see. Now here see 10 at an angle of minus 60 degree. This is polar form or rectangular form?
Polar form.
Right. Okay, here it is in polar form. Now you have to convert it into rectangular, isn't it? So take your calculator, switch it on, and if you see plus and minus sign on calculator, above plus polar is written, above minus rectangular is written, means REC of REC and opening bracket. This one you will find above minus sign. And polar and opening bracket you will find above positive sign. Okay, so these two functions will use to convert polar to rectangular, rectangular to polar. These are written in yellow color, so shift also written in yellow color. Press shift. We wanted to convert polar to rectangular, means you want rectangular form of this. You want a rectangular form of this, that's why on your calculator press shift and minus sign. Once you press shift and minus sign on your display of calculator, you will find rectangular and opening bracket. Then type 10 comma minus 60. Whatever is the magnitude, as it is you have to type 10 comma, you put there, then whatever is the angle, as it is you enter minus 60 degree and complete the bracket. Okay, so again I am repeating, shift minus on display you can see rectangular open brace, then press type 10 comma, separate button is there for comma on calculator, minus 60, complete the bracket, press equal to. Okay, once you press equal to in some calculator, directly it display real part and imaginary part both. Okay, in like x is real part it is displaying and y is imaginary part it is displaying. In some calculator it display only real part, like 5 it is displaying. Rectangular 10 comma minus 60 degree, complete the brackets, equal to real part it is displaying 5, and then imaginary part, if it is not displaying in your calculator, recall, one separate button is there, tan separate button is there. Note down this 5, keep it on display as it is, and then press recall tan. So once you press recall tan, it will display 8.66 minus. Minus 8.66 it is displaying. Okay, got it? So whatever this polar, its rectangular form is this one. Again, I am repeating. See, shift, minus sign, rectangular, opening brace you will get 10, comma, minus 60, complete the bracket, press equal to. In some calculator, directly it display x and y. X as 5 and y as minus 8.66. So x is real part, y is imaginary part. If in some calculator, if it is displaying only real part, that is 5, note it down and let it be as it is, then press recall tan. Two separate buttons are there, recall and tan. Once you press it, it will display imaginary part minus 8.66. So you have to write 5 minus j 8.66 is the rectangular form of this. Is this clear? How to convert polar to rectangular? Got it?
Excuse me, please, ma'am.
Huh?
Ma'am, I have a easier method for this, but it will be manual. We have to do calculations.
Yes. That we know. That one when you can use, when scientific calculators are not allowed in the exam. NPTEL. For NPTEL exam, if you appear, they don't allow scientific calculator. Then whatever you, the method you are telling, that you have to use, that question I was asking. Tell me here, what exactly the calculator does to calculate the real part. Now you can answer. What it is doing? Yes. How will it calculate?
Well, basically, it is taking tan inverse of that angle, and that value of tan inverse will be b by a. Like we are writing it in the format of a plus jb. So we know that how we used to calculate polar form from complex numbers. We used to calculate theta by tan of b by a. So we have to do exactly the same in this type of questions. And tan will be equal to under root a square plus b square. And then we have
two questions. That will see reverse one. 1 minute. That will see reverse one. When the method you are telling me, this is reverse one. Easier, I will tell to you. See, anyone can answer? Yes, how to calculate the real part?
After resolving the into two parts means 10 cos 60 will be in x direction and 10 sin 10 sin 60 will be in
correct 10 sin of minus 60 degree. See here, whatever the real part, that is a is real part and b is imaginary part you have calculated, isn't it? So whatever a you have calculated, it is nothing but it's a m cos phi, isn't it? And b you have calculated, it is m sin phi. Okay, so phi, you how you will get m cos of phi, that is nothing but what calculator programming is done there, m cos phi it is doing, isn't it? And this one, what it is doing? M sine phi. So m sine of minus 60 degree will be minus, isn't it? Sine of minus phi is minus sine phi. That's why imaginary part you are getting here negative. Clear? So in the exams where scientific calculator not allowed, how you can calculate real and imaginary part? M cos phi, m sine phi. Okay. Otherwise, if calculators are allowed, use that rectangular and polar function. So any of the two options, whatever convenient to use, you can use. Got how to convert polar to rectangular? Okay, reverse you do now. Convert this rectangular to polar. So what you have to do, again the same, only you wanted to convert rectangular to polar. So what you will be pressing? Shift plus sign you press, means on screen you can find polar of. Polar of what? What is the real part? 5, comma, minus 8.66, minus 8.66. Complete the bracket and press equal to sign. So it is displaying right now 9.99. Means what? Nothing but 10 you can directly write. Or 9.99 also you can write. It won't affect much. Okay, so magnitude we are getting 9.99, that is 10, I'll write magnitude. And then what you have to press? Recall tan, same, recall tan, it is displaying 59.99, nothing but 60 degree I can find. Okay, so reverse also all of you can try. Polar of this 5, comma, minus 8.66, it will display 10, and then press recall tan, it will display 60 degree. In some calculator directly it display x as magnitude and y as angle. Okay, no need to press recall tan. Or another option, how it calculates calculator 10? Yes, 10 kaise calculate kiya hai while converting this? Right, square root of a square plus b square, isn't it? And how it calculates angle? Tan inverse of imaginary part upon real part. Here it is minus. Minus 60 degree, minus 59.99 it is displaying. So angle will be minus 60 degree. Okay. So tan inverse of imaginary part upon real part will be the angle. Okay. So if calculators are allowed, you can directly use that polar function. Or if it is not allowed or you don't want to use that one function, how you can calculate magnitude? Square root of a square plus b square, that is square of real part plus square of imaginary part. And how you can calculate the angle? Tan inverse of imaginary part upon real part. Okay, so like this, see here, rectangular to polar, this one you can do polar of this, it will display magnitude, then recall tan, you will get the angle. This one also you can try, pi u plus 3j. Okay, any difficulty? Polar to rectangular, rectangular to polar, pi u plus 3j. Try and tell me the answer. Polar of phi u comma 3, complete the bracket, press equal to. So phi u point magnitude you will get 5.83, and what will be the angle? Press recall tan, 30.96. all of you can try this, 30.96 degree. So any difficulty from rectangular to polar or polar to rectangular?
Ma'am, could you please again for rectangular to polar, how to do it?
Same hai, polar function hai aapke calculator mein, shift plus press karo, polar aayega screen pe, type this 5.3, press equal to, you will get 5.83. directly it is displaying x and y, note it down. If not, then press recall tan and you will get the angle. सेम मेथड है जो हमने प्रीवियस इसके लिए किया था. सिर्फ वहां पे हमने रेक्टेंगुलर ऑफ फंक्शन यूज किया था, यहाँ पे पोलर ऑफ. ओके, गेटिंग द आंसर?
यस मैम.
हाँ ठीक है. ओके, कैन वी गो फॉर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक नाउ? एवरीवन गॉट इट? एनी डिफिकल्टी? पोलर टू रेक्टेंगुलर, रेक्टेंगुलर टू पोलर कन्वर्जन. ओके, नेक्स्ट, प्योरली रेजिस्टिव सर्किट. So see, whenever you switch on purely resistive, purely inductive and purely capacitive circuit across single phase AC voltage, what is the current equation? What is the phase difference between voltage and current? What is the phasor diagram? What is the power consumption? What is average power? What is instantaneous power? What is impedance? All these things we are going to see for purely resistive, purely inductive, purely capacitive. Means only if resistance you connect, only if pure inductive coil you connect, only if capacitor you connect. Okay, first three circuits, and then combination of it, like series RL, series RC and series RLC. So for series RL, series RC, series RLC, along with the previous things like instantaneous current equation, phase difference between V and I, instantaneous power, average power, along with this we are going to see additional things like voltage triangle, power triangle, then active, reactive and apparent power, instantaneous power, impedance. Okay, one by one we'll see the theory part. Best whatever we are going to derive here for each circuit, based on that theory questions you will get asked, and whatever the formulas we derive here, whatever the relations we derive here, whatever the concepts we get while analyzing, based on that numericals you will get asked. So everyone please concentrate. And all six types of circuit are there: purely resistive, purely inductive, purely capacitive, series RL, series RC and series RLC. So based on all six circuits, theory questions are there, numericals are there, and any type of circuit you will get asked. Okay, either for numerical or for theory. Got it? You can't skip any circuit. So everyone have to concentrate. So here see, resistance, only resistance means like heater, toaster, iron, these load comes under a resistive type of load. Okay, load means what in electrical engineering? Any equipment which requires electricity for its operation is called as load. Okay, so we are purely a resistive type of load. Whenever you switch on at your home, whenever you switch on any switch at your home, means exactly which supply you switch on, AC or DC? Which one supply is available at your home, AC or DC?
AC.
AC, alternating. Alternating. What is the voltage? It's a single phase or three phase?
Single phase.
Correct. Single, it's a single phase. Whatever the supply available at your home, it's a single phase. One is live phase, it can be with red, yellow or blue color insulation, and another one is neutral phase, which is with black color insulation. If you measure voltage across these two using BMM or voltmeter, how much you will get it? How much voltage will be there across phase and neutral? In socket mein jo do lower terminals rehte hai, ये सॉकेट में अपर वन इज अर्थिंग, लोअर टू आर फेज एंड न्यूट्रल, इजंट इट? दिस वन इज फेज एंड दिस वन इज न्यूट्रल. this one is earthing. So you take DMM or voltmeter and connect it across phase and neutral. So how much volt?
220 volts, man.
How much?
220.
Correct. 220 volt means plus minus 5% tolerance will be there. It can be 200 or 230 you will get, isn't it? So 220 approximately you will get. And what is the supply frequency?
50 hertz.
Okay. So whatever the supply you are getting at your home, it's a single phase 220 volt 50 hertz AC supply. This is called as supply specifications. Okay. So in the socket, lower two are phase and neutral, upper one is earthing. Isn't it? So whenever you switch on single, and this is the symbol for single phase AC voltage. This one. This one is the symbol for single phase AC voltage source. And whatever the single phase AC voltage you are getting at your home, what is its mathematical representation? It starts from zero. Voltage. It starts Vm sin of omega t. Correct. Whatever the voltage you are getting at your home, its mathematical expression is V of t, Vm sin of omega t. And this one waveform number of times we have seen, starts from origin, increasing positively, first positive peak occurs at 90 degree. Isn't it? At 180 degrees value is zero, then further increases, then at 270 degree first negative peak occurs, and so on at 360 degree again zero. Okay, so that one voltage, graphical representation, let me show you this one waveform. It is nothing but whenever you switch on voltage at your home, like this voltage you are going to apply. So whenever you switch on single phase AC voltage across resistive, inductive, capacitive, RL, RC and RLC, what happens we are going to see. Some relationship we are going to derive here. Now see here, suppose I am going to connect one ammeter here in the circuit, or suppose I am going to connect one voltmeter across this resistance. So whatever this AC type of voltmeter and ammeter, they display which value? RMS or peak? Whatever the voltmeters and ammeters you connect in the circuit, ammeters in series and voltmeter in parallel, AC type, alternating type. So these gives which value? RMS or peak value, or instantaneous or average? RMS, root mean square value. They display root mean square value. Okay. So, whatever the current here I have shown, it is the root mean square value you can consider. Capital I, root mean square value. Okay. So, what will be the instance? Here resistances are, voltage is V of t, Vm sin of omega t. So, you can write the instantaneous current equation. I of t is equals to V of t by R. V of t, Vm sin of omega t. So, what will be Vm by R here? You will get Vm maximum by R. Current. What is Vm by R?
Maximum current.
Correct. Maximum current. That is Im. Okay. You will get it. Im. Sometimes for 1 mark MCQ question, value of resistance given to you, instantaneous voltage equation given to you, and they will ask you calculate either Im or IRMS. So how you will be calculating? Vm by R is Im, and then Im you can convert into IRMS. Im divided by root 2 will be the IRMS. Okay, so this Vm by R you can replace by Im, so you will get instantaneous current equation. I of t is Im sin of omega t, where Im is Vm by R. So compare both the equations now. Voltage equation is V of t, Vm sin of omega t. Current equation means whenever you switch on single phase AC voltage across resistive type of load, purely resistive type of load, then whatever the current flowing, its mathematical expression is what? I of t, Im sin of omega t. Compare both the equations. Is there any phase difference between voltage across that resistance and current flowing through that resistance? No phase difference. Okay, no phase difference is there between the voltage and current. Whatever is the phase difference between voltage, total voltage and total current is denoted by angle phi. And cosine of this angle is called as power factor. Okay, power factor means what? Cos phi. Whenever I say power factor is cos phi, cosine of some angle phi. So this angle phi is nothing but what? What is it? Phi? It's the phase difference between total voltage and total current. Okay. So here, what is the phase difference between total voltage and total current?
Zero degrees.
So what will be the cos of 0 degree?
One.
So power factor you are getting here? One. Okay. MCQ question for purely resistive load. Is there any phase difference or what is the phase difference between total voltage and total current? For purely resistive load, what is the phase difference between total voltage and total current?
Zero degree.
What is the power factor?
One.
Okay. So how you will represent both the phasors? We have seen phasor diagram. Vm sine of omega t, Im sine of omega t, it will be along positive real axis and both you have to measure from same common point. Consider this is the origin O. So you have to measure both the phasors from same common point. So suppose V 2 centimeter and I from same origin 1 centimeter, both will be in phase. Okay, so no phase difference. This is the phasor diagram for purely resistive load. Sometimes you get asked, what is the impedance? Impedance means along with the resistance, whenever in AC circuit, inductor is there, capacitor is there. So whatever is the opposition to the flow of current is marked as Z, impedance. Its unit is also ohm. So here only resistance is there. So impedance is equals to R. Sometimes you get asked, calculate the impedance. It is nothing but R, which is equals to Vm by Im. Isn't it? Vm by Im is R, or Vrms by Irms is R. Ratio will be same. Vm by Im or Vrms by Irms ratio will be same. Now you know voltage equation, you know instantaneous current equation. If you take its product, you will get the instantaneous power. Instantaneous parameters get represented by small letters. So small p function of time, instantaneous power is product of instantaneous voltage and product of instantaneous current. So voltage and current equation we know. Put it here, simplify. Sine square omega t, you will get sine square omega t, you can replace by 1 minus cos of 2 omega t upon 2, isn't it? Yes, have you learned this formula in 12th?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, okay. Then simplify the step. simplify it. So you will get Vm Im by 2 constant part, because if you know Vm Im divided by 2, some constant value you will get, constant part. And the another one is Vm Im by 2 means minus Vm Im by 2 cos of 2 omega t. Here you are getting fluctuating part, that is the cosine waveform. Okay, now what was the supply voltage? Vm sine of omega t. What is its angular frequency? Omega. You know this waveform, it completes from 0 to pi. This is Vm sine of omega t. Average value for alternating quantity we take from 0 to pi or 0 to 2 pi. We have seen average value is 0.637 times the peak value. That time I told you average value is considered from 0 to pi, because from 0 to 2 pi it will be 0, isn't it? For Vm sine of omega t, Im sine of omega t. That's why it is considered from 0 to pi. Now for, see this one is a cos of 2 omega t waveform, means twice the supply frequency. Supply frequency is Vm sine of omega t, omega it is. And this one is 2 times omega t, isn't it? Cos of 2 omega t means twice the supply frequency. What does it mean? If the voltage source completes one cycle from 0 to 2 pi, that is positive half cycle from 0 to pi. So cos of 2 omega t as twice the supply frequency, how many cycle it will complete from 0 to pi? ट्वाइस द सप्लाई वन कंप्लीट कर दी अगर ये पॉजिटिव हाफ कंप्लीट कर रहा है तो दिस वन कॉस ऑफ 2 omega t, it will complete one cycle. Then for this, from cos of 2 omega t, what will be the average value from 0 to pi? Because for alternating quantities, we will consider, it will be 0. Okay, so average, this is the instantaneous power equation simplified you are getting. So average of this will be the 0. See here, 0 I have written. And what will be the average of this? Suppose this parameter is coming 80, Vm, Im divided by 2. It is coming 80. What is the average of 80? 80, isn't it? So this parameter constant part, it is will remain as it is. So average power we are getting Vm, Im by 2. This is the instantaneous power. Up to this, instantaneous power. Now we are interested in finding out the average power. So average power, average of this will be the 0, average of this will be the as it is, Vm Im by 2, you can write Vm by root 2, Im by root 2. And what is Vm by root 2, Im by root 2? Vrms into Irms, isn't it? So what average power we are getting? V into I. Okay, as here it is a cos phi 1, actually for AC circuit formula for active power, capital P here is nothing but its active power. When we go for RL, RC and RFC, we'll derive the active power is VI cos phi. And here cos phi is 1. That's why average power you are getting only V into I. For all AC circuits, only one formula you keep here in your mind of power, capital P, that is the average power is VI cos phi. So in this circuit cos phi, we got cos of 0 degree, that is 1. That's why V into I. That's why you can put here V is equals to IR. So if you put V is equals to IR, you will get I square R. If you replace I by V by R, you will get V square by R. So for purely resistive circuit, whenever you get asked to calculate the average power, any of this formula you can use to calculate the average power. Sometimes they give instantaneous voltage equation and value of resistance and you will get asked to calculate the average power. Okay, so V into I you use or V square by R you use or I square R you use. Unit is watt. So what is the conclusion for this purely resistive circuit? Voltage equation is V of t Vm sine of omega t. Current equation is I of t Im sine of omega t. Concentrate this because sometimes they don't mention which type of circuit it is. Only instantaneous voltage equation and instantaneous current equation they give. Suppose V of t Vm sine of omega t and I of t Im sine of omega t is given. Means it is which type of circuit? No phase difference is there between voltage and current. And in which circuit no phase difference is there between voltage and current? Only for purely resistive. So it is a purely resistive. You have to identify in the numericals. Okay. Then what is the, how you will calculate Im? Here. Vm by R. Is there any phase difference between voltage and current? No phase difference. What is cos phi? 1. What is instantaneous power equation? Vm Im sine square omega t. What is average power? V into I. That is which one V and which one I? RMS, not the peak. If you are solving the average power using peak, then your answer will be wrong. Which one values you have to use here? Of V and I?
RMS.
RMS. Okay, phasor diagram we have seen. Phasor diagram. Impedance, if you get asked, it will be equal to R. Okay, so this is about the purely resistive circuit. This is the graphical representation of the waveforms for purely resistive circuit. V of t, Vm sine of omega t. This one number of times we have seen. I of t, Im sine of omega t, no phase difference between voltage and current for purely resistive circuit, isn't it? So current also will be in phase, only magnitude will be different. Okay, so like this will be the graphical representation of Vm sine of omega t and Im sine of omega t for purely resistive load. What instantaneous power equation we got? Instantaneous power equation we got Vm Im sine square omega t. So in this equation, omega t you go on putting from 0 to infinity. So you will get its graphical representation like this. This is the instantaneous power. Okay. And what's about the average power we got? VRMS into IRMS. So it will be a line parallel to x-axis. Okay. It will be a line parallel to x-axis with some magnitude equal to VRMS into IRMS. Okay. So graphical representation, got it? Any difficulty? Next one we'll see, purely inductive load. So this is about the purely resistive. Whatever the things we have seen with purely resistive, same things you have to learn for purely inductive type of load. Okay. Attendance link I posted in chat box. Everyone please mark attendance. Next one load we'll see. That is the purely inductive load. See here. Here you have to consider one coil. Okay. Any copper coil with few turns. So coil, its self inductance is denoted by capital L. Self inductance, its unit is Henry or millihenry. Millihenry means, milli means into 10 to the power minus 3. So self inductance, it is the property of a coil which opposes the change in current through it. Means in this circuit, if you are increasing the current, due to its self-inductance property, it will oppose the rise in current. If you are decreasing the current, due to its self-inductance property, it will oppose the decrease in current. Okay. Whenever every coil, means any coil you take, it is having some resistance also. Every coil, it is having always, means this is self-inductance it has and some value of resistance it has. Always and some inductance and some value of self inductance and some value of resistance, small r, capital L. Always, none of the coil is purely inductive, always it is having some resistance. Got it? But here, purely inductive means neglect this resistance, consider purely inductive coil. Okay, purely inductive coil. Means it don't have any internal resistance. So like this coil, when you switch on across single phase AC voltage, V of T, Vm, sin of omega T. So what will happen here? AC current is flowing through the circuit. Whenever you pass AC current through the conductor, round it, it produces changing magnetic field. If you pass DC current, direct current, through the conductor, round it, it produces stationary magnetic field. AC changing, DC stationary. Okay. So here AC current you are passing. So round it, it will produce changing magnetic field around this coil like this. Now coil is stationary. This changing magnetic field produced because of AC current is coming in contact with this coil. What will happen as per Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction? AC current is flowing through inductive coil. As AC current is flowing because of it, round it, it produces changing magnetic field. That changing magnetic field is coming in contact with the coil. So what will happen as per Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction?
EMF will be induced.
Correct. EMF get induced in the coil. It will be E equals to minus L di by dt. That EMF as per Lenz law will oppose the cause producing it. That's why here minus sign is there. And if you see the direction here, whatever the polarity of supply voltage and this induced EMF will be opposite to each other. That's why we can write V of t is equals to minus E. So put here value of E. You will get V of t is equals to L di by dt. Put V of t, Vm sin of omega t. Simplify it. You can write this equation as it is. Take integration on both the sides. What is integration of di? I of t. What is integration of sin of omega t with respect to dt? It's minus cos of omega t upon omega. So minus sign you can take out. Isn't it? What is omega L? Is a XL. What is cos of omega t? You can replace it by sine of pi by 2 minus omega t. And here minus sign is there. So this one minus sine of pi by 2 minus omega t, I can write as a plus sine omega t minus pi by 2. And here omega L parameter is there. That one we can represent as XL. So Vm by XL is Im. So what instantaneous current equation you are getting? I of t is Im sine of omega t minus pi by 2. And V of t is what? Applied voltage. V of t Vm sine of omega t. Now compare both the equation. So here minus sign is there. Means current is lagging or leading voltage? Minus lagging. Correct. By how much angle?
90 degrees.
So phase difference, what is for purely inductive circuit? What is the phase difference between voltage and current? MCQ question, 90 degree.
Minus 90 degree.
90 degree. Phase difference is 90 degree. Current lags or leads?
Lags.
Current lags. Okay, current lags voltage by 90 degree.